Welcome to another edition of FLIR PRIMED. I'm Grant Coffey. HME, homemade explosives. These are, at their simplest, a simple chemical mixture of a fuel, think the red placard, and an oxidizer, think the yellow placard. Couple this with confinement, as in some sort of a container, and a way to set it off, like a fuse, you've got yourself a bomb. The mixtures for this, the chemicals, or we call precursors, are available pretty much in the community at any store, and in many cases at a home kitchen. But make no mistake about it, a home kitchen HME lab is an extremely dangerous place. Let's take a look at some of the common HME precursors or chemical components that make up these mixes that you can identify on scene. Some typical ones are common acids. Sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid is used in car batteries. Sometimes you'll see it in drain cleaners. Muriatic acid. That's hydrochloric acid used in containers for brick cleaner that you'll find at some hardware stores. Hydrogen peroxide, especially the type that's very strong that you'll see in hair salons. And citric acid. Sometimes you'll see that in cooking stores or box stores, used in some kitchens for cooking. And also nitrate-based chemicals. One of those is a fertilizer, or you can even find it in cold packs as nitrate prill. Take any mixture of these precursor chemicals, mix them in the right concentrations, the right purity, you'll get yourself a touch-sensitive explosive, extremely dangerous. Part of the issue is these mixes also produce byproducts that are in themselves toxic and explosive. There are key actions on HME scenes that are incredibly important, and trust me, your life may depend on these. Number one, if you recognize an HME lab, by labware, PPE, many of these precursor chemicals, recognize that, back out and call for help. Call for the cavalry. Get a law enforcement and hazmat teams there to help you. Always, I repeat, always suspect the secondary device. Rule it out. Many of these labs have booby traps and secondary devices associated with them. So after you secure the scene, don't touch anything. Don't touch anything beyond your pay grade. That's incredibly important. Once you're on these scenes and you've pulled back, you have a joint operation with law and hazmat professionals, we would like to identify the chemicals if we can. One of the best ways is to sample for trace chemicals in particulate with a swab like this. The swab will be read by one of these detectors, explosives trace detector, put into here, and we can analyze and tell very specifically in several libraries a whole class of chemicals based on these precursors. Then law enforcement can use that in the job that they do. If you follow protocols, use the right equipment, and work with your partners, you can keep yourself very safe on these dangerous HME scenes. We have some excellent downloads on other HME precursor agents that you can get at flir.com/prime. Thanks for watching another episode of FLIR PRIMED.